for. Nice afternoon.
I'm sad to see daylight savings go.
I know. It's always a little hard to, when the or the sun sets
darker
before
sooner.
6. Yeah. So, but tomorrow, so tonight when you head to bed, make sure to set your clocks back and, of course, check your fire alarm batteries. It's always a good time to check on that as well. Well, temperature-wise this afternoon, not too bad. We actually hit near normal temperatures across the area. Here's a live look at our Hill Country camera. Beautiful blue skies right now. Very clear conditions. We have very dry air in place. Temperatures for the rest of the evening will drop into the 50s by 9 p.m. Right now, 67, 62 by 7 p.m. And by 9 p.m., we'll drop down into the mid-50s. Currently at Camp Mabry, clear skies, 67 degrees and 69 out at the airport with dew points in the low 30s. So we still have that dry air in place. That combined again, like yesterday, with the clear skies, calmer wind conditions, those temperatures are going to fall fast through the overnight hours. Right now, our winds are out of the east-southeast, 5 and 6 miles an hour. Temperatures across the area, still right around 70 in Llano right now. It's 66, though, in Georgetown, 69 in Bastrop, and 66 degrees currently in LaGrange. Across the state, temperatures range from the low 70s out to the west to near 60 in Shreveport right now, 63 in Dallas, and 63 currently in Houston. A little cooler on the eastern half of the state. Satellite radar shows that at least our sky conditions statewide are not any different than what we're experiencing here in central Texas. Clear skies all across the area, high ridge of high pressure in place, but you notice now it's further to our east along the surface, so that's kicking up those southerly winds. That's going to help bring a little bit more moisture into the area, especially starting on Monday into the first part of your work week. Now, on the upper levels of the atmosphere, we'll continue to see this ridge of high pressure in place. It moves just slowly out to the east all the way through your Monday, so our conditions aren't going to change a whole lot through the rest of your weekend. Tonight, again, another chilly night, but tomorrow afternoon, temperatures even warm up a couple more degrees with that southerly flow really kicking in. And by Monday, the same sort of trend continues. Overnight temperatures a little bit warmer, afternoon highs a little bit warmer as well. Tonight, though, here's what you can expect across the area. Temperatures in the Hill Country, mid to upper 30s. That's a little bit warmer than it was last night, but that's still pretty cold to start out on your Sunday morning. Mid to upper 30s, a few places in the low 40s here in the metro area, and then upper 30s and low 40s along our eastern counties. For tomorrow, temperatures again through the afternoon, just a degree or two warmer. Low 70s, I should say, to our northern and then to our northern counties and our southern counties. We'll all see the mid 70s through the afternoon hours. Tonight, 43 degrees with clear skies out there, a light wind out of the south and southeast. For tomorrow, 74, your afternoon high. And of course, remember to set your clocks back tonight. Can't remind you enough. And check those fire alarm batteries. But you're going to see temperatures Monday, Tuesday already warming up, nearing 80. That's well above normal for this time of year before a cold front could roll in late next week. That also brings us a small chance of a shower Thursday night and into Friday as of right now, and then cool us down into next weekend.
Now, local sports with Brian Sanders.
Well, good evening. Kansas State hasn't been the best place for Texas in recent years, but the Longhorns need their luck to change tonight. Roger Wallace is in Manhattan, counting down to kickoff.
Longhorns are going to be outnumbered certainly this evening against Kansas State, but that's the way they've liked it this year. Texas trying to go a perfect 4-0 in true road games.
Usually when you go on the road, the key is turnovers and kicking game, and I think that we've talked about it a whole lot, and there's been a lot said about what's bad about this team. There are a lot of great things about this team. The things that are bad are we've got to score in the red zone. If we score last week in the red zone, we win the game, and we need to come up with more turnovers. And it's easier to come up with turnovers if you get them behind. We've been even in most ball games, and people are running the ball, and they're not throwing it, and it's easier to get turnovers when somebody else is having to throw it, and they're more predictable. So what we've got to